Mama, mommy, do you have my red boots? Got me my red boots. Where'd my arm go, mommy? Where'd my arm go? It's a Zodi's goddamn 666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666666 got bullshit, I got recommendations, I got jabba jabba jabba. Yeah, it was my birthday, August 11th, so I got a lot of cool shit from that. The wife has hooked me up. Let me see, first off, I'll go ahead and show you this. A beauty. Beauty. Ever since I seen this son of a bitch in Tear for Tom's video, I was like, I have to have it. I know you can't see it too well, but you know that man is. That is a toxic Avenger. Look at that beautiful mop. But yes, I was very happy to get this. Really cool. Got some shit on the back. It's got Darkman, American Werewolf in London, that Nazi, whatever he is, monster, werewolf, whatever you want to call him. Pretty damn nice. So I was very happy to see that. You know I love my Toxie. She also got me this one here, Toxic Crusaders. You know, Toxic Crusaders, Toxic Crusaders. And, oh my god, my telephone. Alexandria Graham Bell on line 2. Yeah, this is the Toxic Crusaders movie. Just a good little thing to have in the collection. I enjoyed that one. Really weird old, you know. I remember watching those old cartoons. I didn't really understand. I think by the time I seen those cartoons, I don't think I seen Toxic Avenger yet. I may be wrong. I don't know. That's a shame. What else I get? Oh yeah, check this out. She got me this. Had to hook me up with the zombie head. It's very nice. I know it's been in a lot of other videos, but let me see. You open that son of a bitch up. You got your Blu-rays in there. See, 8, man. You know, I seen your video, man, when you're like, I don't have The Walking Dead. Where is he going to sign it? See, what you can do, here is you can take this son of a bitch out, and you can have him sign that, and you can put it right back in there and do like that. And then when some people come over, you'd be like, hey, you want to see the signature? You open it up like that, and then you just do like that, and you say, hey, look, there's a signature. And it's hidden, you know? You know what I'm saying? But yeah, you know, you got the screwdriver comes out of the eyeball, which is a very, very cool touch, I thought. But it's nice. It's nice. His head's almost as big as mine. What a big head. Alright, and then, oh, got more stuff over here. This is a mixed bag here. Her sister got me these. This is pretty cool. Went and got some old, like, Boris Karloff comic books. Got these bomb-ass covers on them, you know? Gotta love that old horror artwork. That shit's badass. You know, got me a bunch of those. Margarita almost got, or let me see. Yeah, my wife also got me this here. Demons, Devils, and, or Devils, Demons, and Witchcraft. I just always, I'm not a religious person. I don't really have a, I don't care about it at all. But I've always been interested in these old, you know, the artwork from like the early days where they had the old Baphomet and all that stuff. I just really think that shit's cool. But it's got a lot of cool artwork and shit in here. There he is. There he is. He's got titties. So that was really cool. Then, alright, also, let's see. I want to give a big shout out to my buddy. Is it Stu yet, Clay, man? Thank you so much. He said, he just, out of the blue, I get this package in the mail around my birthday, and it was like, I should have opened this on video. I didn't know what it was. I just seen it. It was an Amazon package, so I opened it up, and it's like, I could tell it was a DVD, but it was in this like blue wrapping, and it had a little card on it, and I was like, okay. So I opened it up, and I'm like, wait a minute. So I opened the card, and it says 20D666, you know, your buddy Clay. He sent this to me for my birthday. We were just talking about it, and he just sent it to me, and I do have something for you on the way. You better get it soon, damn it. I ordered that thing like the 24th, but anyway, but no, I hope you like what you get, man. I'll be doing a review on this one soon, man. Thank you so much. This really meant a lot. Like, I know Clay's a pretty new dude, and I haven't, you know, we correspond back and forth, but just that, I can't believe you wanted to send me something. That's just, that blows me away. It was really, really cool of you, man. Good guy. And then Traffic Cone Man, he sent me this here. Traffico, man, he's been with me for a couple years now. Always been a great dude, always supportive, man, always fucking super nice. He's part of the cheese family. But yeah, I can't wait to check this one. It's an Asian, like, killer boar movie. So, yeah, I mean, I can't wait. This looks like a really fun one. I should have checked it out already. It seems like every time I try to watch that, when I get interrupted and I have to go do something, it's like, when I go do something and get interrupted, it's like, is that the microphone I coughed into? You all are going to get sick and die. Shit. Then, you know, Dante, Jesus. So mighty. I got these, sorry. Dante Tomaselli, the dude that did, Horror, he did Desecration, he did, God damn it, that Satan's Playground. Like, when I first seen Horror, like, I was just like, I didn't know what to think. And then I went back and watched. That is a damn good movie. But anyway, I just think this dude's a really talented director and shit. He hooked me up, man. I just talked to him on Facebook one day. He decided to send me a bunch of his free, you know, he signed a bunch of stuff here. Whoops, that's upside down. But, I mean, he's just cool, you know. I know Vance has talked to him and Horace Ball has talked to him. Just been really cool to everybody. You know, he just signed stuff like Welcome to My Nightmare and stuff like that. So everybody, when this, when that Torture Chamber comes out, I think everybody should pick this one up. This looks like it's going to be some cool shit. He's always got some really trippy, weird shit, and I like that. He's got a really, really cool style. So I got those. Let's see. Now, yeah, what do I got to say about this? You guys, I mean, you know, you already know that I would be into this. You guys, pretty much everybody's talked about it. So all the thing I'm going to say is, if you're watching my channel and you don't own this, go buy it. I'm not going to give you a review of it because I'm a dick. Anyway, no, but it's good, man. Especially the end part of that. It was just like, it blew me away. The end of that movie was just like, holy shit, they took it to another level. This is nuts. Chris Buckman's the man. All right, and then I got this one from MVD. Day of Violence, yeah, man, I was excited for this one. I wanted to like this one. Which got here is fuck, I forgot where it was from. God damn it. Well, it's a, anyway, I think it's British? Or all shit, I don't know! Anyway, Day of Violence, man, yeah, you see the dude on the cover, he's all beat to shit. I may need to go back and watch this one again. My first viewing of it, I don't know. It's basically what it is it's this dude. He works for debt collectors, and you know, so they go. They're like, oh well, this dude didn't pay up. You better go to his house and, you know, go take care of him and get the money and shit. So the dude goes to his house, and the guy has the money. So what is? Yeah, it's Mitchell. The main guy's name is Mitchell. He decides, the debt collector. He decides he's just gonna take that dude's money, kill him, and strike out. So yeah, so these people are just going around looking for him. It's just, I don't know, it did have some cool violent scenes. It's just, I don't know, the main character, he just was not believable. I know I watch a lot of crazy shit, but for something like this, I think it needed to be more believable and have better acting. It just, I don't know, like I said, I'm gonna give it another watch and give it another go, but I'm not sure about that one. Then I got this one MVD, Night of Living Dead Reanimated. This is a cool, little companion piece if you guys, you know, you big Night of Living Dead fans out there. Basically what this one is, it uses the audio from the movie, and, they just do, like, different animators and illustrators and shit like that. People working with, puppets, people working with dolls. They make up the scenes of the movie along with the dialogue. Some of it was pretty damn cool, and then again, some of it, I just did not see, like, some of it I thought was pretty crappy, like the art. I don't want to be a jerk, I'm not an artist or anything, but I do appreciate good art, but, there's a lot of stuff in this that was really cool, original, you know, inventive and shit, and then there was some stuff in here that just, you know, it's like an illustration of a picture, and they're like, it's just filming a picture and going with the dialogue. That kind of stuff was a little, bleh. But not too bad. It's definitely, like I said, it's cool to have if you're a big collector of Night of the Living Dead. Then I got this. Another one from MVD. They sent this to me earlier. It took me I watched a while back, but I've been lazy. I've been playing Transformers on Xbox 360, so yeah, sue me. But yeah, whoops. From Unearthed and Lucifer Valentine, Black Metal Veins. Now, I did get the cut version, but I'm guessing the only thing that I'm missing, you know, from the uncut version is like a little bit of that, the sex that they had going on. But anyway, this is, okay, for those of you who don't know, Lucifer Valentine, he did this, you know, Vomit Gore Trilogy, which those are some pretty fucked up movies. But this one here, they're their own thing. This one here is a documentary on heroin and junkies. It basically follows around like four, you know, is it four? Let me see. About five different people. They're just hanging out in the house. He's hanging out with them. He's asking them personal questions. They go off and tell him the most personal shit, you know. And they're just shooting up, smoking crack, having a good old time. For those of you that like really dark documentaries and just a weird, and he's got, his style though, but this is really, he's got his style in this, but it's a straight up documentary. It was, I thought it was really, really well done. Yeah, I urge everybody to go check this one out. Definitely worth picking that son of a bitch up. Then, Infernal Films, Lars was a good enough dude. He sent me this movie. He sent me a poster and stuff too. I need to show that off in one of these videos. But he sent me a screener of Necronos. Now, those of you that have heard about Necronos, you know that it's going to be getting a trauma release pretty soon. So that's pretty cool. But yeah, he sent me this and his other movie. It came with, it was pretty cool. It came with little, stills. Like, some of these are dirty birdies, but, oh. That's a titty. That is a titty and a vagina. But anyway, let me get to the review. You don't care about these. You don't care about the pictures that I want to show you. So go to hell. So yeah. Oh my god, I'm sweating in this mask. Oh Jesus. Yeah, Necronos. Now this was fucking nuts. Alright. This is one out of Germany. Now the production, I'm not saying the storyline or anything like that, but the production value and the gore and stuff like that, which the gore isn't as good as Olaf Ittenbach, but the production value and stuff and just the mayhem of this movie, you know, it reminded me of reminiscent, like the same kind of quality that The Burning Moon had. So if you can get into The Burning Moon and then you add like a layer of cheese on top of that, and some demons and Satan thrown into it as well, you know, along with crazy gore and shit like that, then you will dig Necronos. The only complaint I had about this movie, it's like a little over 2 hours long. And I think, like, you know, a fun gore fest like this should keep it at an hour and 30 minutes. But that's just because I'm, you know, I got an ADD, so. But yeah, this one, this plot's nuts. I'm just going to try to shorten it up. Basically, it's about this demon from hell named Necronos. He comes to Earth. You know, Satan sends him to Earth so he can build an army of the undead to take over the world. He's got some minions. Excuse me. God, I didn't mean that. I didn't mean excuse me. I don't mean it. He's got some minions. He's got a blood demon called Goran. He goes around and pretty much slaughters everybody. Necronos is trying to build to get ingredients to build these things called berserkers. They're like the most powerful of the undead, but he needs certain ingredients like brains and, like, you know, the heart of a man and the heart of a woman and this and that. So he's trying to get all this shit. Also, they're looking for the chosen one, which is like this witch that's pure, that hasn't had sex yet, so a virgin witch. They're trying to look for that also because they need her blood to help Satan power up. And this movie is it's out there, man. Like, I enjoyed it, man. I thought, like I said, there's really no complaints from me. I said the running time is a little long, and I'll stand to that. But other than that, this is like a great gory cheese fest, man. Really fun. It has good gore. Just really, it brought it back to the old school for me. Like, old school German splatter, you know? Not like, you know, it's no, like, what the hell is the name of that movie? Das Combat Duel or whatever? That, no. This is better. Trust me. This is like some old Olaf. But yeah, no. Give it a chance, man. If you can deal with a little cheese with your gore, go ahead and give this one a chance. It'll be coming out soon on Trauma. And then I got this one, Night of This Earth. had to pick this one up. I'm going to Spooky in October, and Tracy Lords is going to be there, so I'm going to try to have her sign this. But yeah, this is a fun one. Now, there's actually not a lot of, like, creature stuff. You know, the cover looks awesome. You got Tracy Lords there. You got the alien and shit. Looks all badass. But you don't really see aliens or nothing like that. You do see some, like, full moon style eyeball effects, you know, where he shoots lasers out of his eyes. He sucks, sucks people's life force out. Tracy Lords is like a nurse in this movie. So this weird guy comes to town and he hires her to be his own private nurse. And she starts seeing weird stuff because she's living in with him. So he's acting real weird. There's people coming in. They're not leaving. You know, he's got this other dude that's like his other like chauffeur type guy. He's an ex-criminal, so he's always trying to hit on Tracy Lords, and he's trying to be, you know, he's kind of like the comedy, you know, the comedy, whatever, man. But yeah, good fun cheese fest. Oh, shit. Then I got Mystics in Bali, and oh my god, this movie is balls out crazy. Love Mondo Macabro. I've been wanting to see this forever. It's been on my wish list forever. I finally just broke down and said, I'm buying this son of a bitch. I don't regret that shit at all. I mean, this one's just, it's basically, this is chick from America. She goes to Bali, and she's going to, like, try to, you know, she's, like, researching magic. So she tries to find this, you know, great magician and this and that, and the black magic, black arts, and, she's just like, teach me how to, you know. So she meets this old decrepit lady in the woods, and she starts teaching her the ways of magic, and it's just, the effects in this and everything are just balls out. I mean, I could try to show the pictures on the back. The best thing to do would be go check out this trailer if you know nothing about it, because the trailer will tell you what you're in for. Mystics in Bali. That's definitely recommended. That's awesome. Then I got this one by old Johnny Dickey. Slaughter Tales. He was like 13 years old when he made this. Look at this. For one, look at this. Look at the packaging. This is some nice stuff. You got the box here. It's like old VHS box. You know. Now this, you know, for being as young as he is and not living through the VHS era, like, he totally, for me, I think he totally got the fun feel of a cool, like, not saying this is shot on, like, VHS video, but it still got that feel of shot on VHS video. It's got that, I don't know, man, this kid, he's, I think he's gonna be, you know, he's gonna keep on keeping on. This is, like, for the fans of super cheese, old 80s, you know, shot on video, bad movies. Anybody that's into that can watch some video violence or watch some, you know, other shit like that. I can't think of anything right now. I'm retarded. But just like it's almost like an anthology. It's got these little shorts on there that kind of make up. Basically what it is Johnny Dickey's chilling on his couch. He goes and steals a VHS from the video store, takes it back to his house. He's hanging out watching a movie, so he's kind of like reacting to his own movie. You know, he's like, oh, that was garbage, that's ridiculous. So, I mean, like I said, he does all the effects himself. He's a real talented dude. He did a lot of these scenes all by himself, just set the camera up, did it. I don't know, you know, and he, you know, he's aware that this is like a corny, cheesy, you know, just nut fest. So, he had fun making it. I had fun watching it. I recommend it. Like I said, though, for anybody that does not like shot on video or, like, cheesy shit from the 80s, you might not like that one, but I really thought it was cool. Then, you know, I just got little stuff in, like, this, House of Mysterious Secrets. I just decided to get 11x17 of that. Had to. They sent me a free Day of the Dead poster, which I thought was really cool. And House of Mysterious Secrets are actually really, really nice guys. But yeah, they sent me that Day of the Dead poster, 11x17 for free, and then I got this beautiful Taint poster with the shirt. They signed it up. Now when you get the Taint poster, just give you a heads up, this is paper. Under here, under this frame and everything, it's paper. It's printed on paper, so just a heads up. It's not like a glossy finish or nothing, it's just paper. But look at that artwork. You still gotta love the art. And I signed it up, got the shirt. You know how I do. And what else do I have? can't see anything. Had to pick this up. Nail Gun Massacre. Look at that beautiful Frightmare video VHS. This is I think I paid about, I don't know, $15 for this. I figured why not. I'm a fan of the flick. God damn it, I can't get it right. I'm a fan of the flick. It's just ridiculous. Fun stuff. You get this on a red VHS. You know, every now and then you have to pick up some VHS. I can't help it. Like, that's the only thing I need is to start collecting some other shit. Jesus Christ. But yeah, I had to pick up Junior. I got this off a buddy off Facebook. Got Junior. Got some movie called The Plumber. I just thought that was a great title. It just sounds ridiculous. The Plumber. And then I got this one just because it had a cool cover and he gave me a good deal. So, The Ghosting. So, looks cool. I don't know nothing about that. No. Yeah, that's about it. It's a 20-minute fucking video. So, yeah. So, I want to thank everybody. I want to thank Traffic Home Man. I want to thank his Stu Yet. I'd like to thank my wife. I'd like to thank Jesus Christ and Satan. And I'd like to thank Lucifer, my kitty cat. And I'd like to thank Odin and Prissy. And I hope we all can play together. Wait a minute. Wait. That is how I do it. That is how I do it, baby.